I'm David Edel, and I make golf clubs. When I started making golf clubs, I bought a really old milling machine and was working out of another building that the machine didn't really fit in, and said, okay, I'm gonna build a shop, and it was a 25 by 30 building. Thought I moved into the Taj Mahal. I had absolutely no idea what I was doing. Find a machine, and I wasn't worried about how to use it. I was more worried about breaking tooling. You know, that's real easy to do with a $60 cutter, and you make one bad move and then bink, it's broken. You have to make mistakes, and you have to be willing to have 30 hours of work just get flushed down the toilet.
Launching our iron was probably our most difficult task. Most companies have a bunch of money to throw in MIG forging dies and 3D models. We don't have that luxury, so we kind of reverse engineered something out of a block of steel. Tons of handwork. I mean, we were putting 3 to 4 hours into each golf club. Torching, bending hosels, making sure the offset was correct, machining our own grooves. We were doing it on a shoestring budget, and we came up with just an unbelievable product. I mean, it's a true game-changing iron. We still sell it. David's an innovator, always has been. That's where his mind's always at.
I'm 24/7 thinking about golf, thinking about how to make a better golf club, and having an idea with a putter that you're thinking, well, how do I make something that's going to be so different than what anybody else has done? That's the fun part. And this is a company in the pursuit of making people better golfers. I know my customer. I know their name. We hand make that product bespoke for that individual because everybody's unique.
Me and Dave were trying to make, 300, 400 wedges by hand every month with not a lot of room and not a lot of machinery. We made it work, and that's kind of where me and him grew in terms of how we talked about golf clubs, products, future.
We've had to survive. I mean, I went for 18 years without really making a profit. But I never quit. Kept trying. Luckily, I had some good supporters.
I've been down in a lot of finances to make this happen. A lot of time and effort away from family, and without their support, I don't think I'd be where I am right now.
My parents, my dad's gone now, but... they supported me a lot. Said, what the hell are you doing? But they were always there supporting me. So if they didn't believe in what I was doing, or those first few fitters that fit for me didn't help, I wouldn't be here. Just start off small. It doesn't have to be big. I started off small in a garage, and I made something out of it. Roughly about 2 years ago, we were able to connect with some really amazing people over in Japan, and we had a lot of units we had to make. I was like, oh my God, we had to make 1,000 putters in a month, and we were like, we'd never even come close to that, right? As a team, we were able to put that behind us and get through it, and we got it done. And for years, I'd talk about what I was doing, but the other systems were so entrenched in everybody's mind, they didn't really look at fitting as a business model. And then, I was able to help a young man go on to win the US Amateur and the NCAA National Championship with single length golf clubs. And in the process of working with him, I was able to develop a fitting model in single length, which has never been done before.
Single length golf is revolutionary. We got some major champions that started playing our wedges that were idols of mine growing up. Instant validation, if a tour player is going to play the product and put it in play, they trust that golf club. So it was pretty neat to be making those golf clubs for people that, I've watched play golf since I was a young kid.
I want to be regarded as somebody that was a great steward to the game. You just can't quit. It takes no talent to quit. Not many people maybe ever realize that they have skills or where their true passion could go if they really stuck to it. And I can honestly say, I decided to do it and I never stopped.
We've had a lot of professionals that have come to us with some pretty crazy, wild, sexy ideas, and we haven't said no to any yet.